Hi there, lovely subscribers. Today I am going to make a Dutch lesson about diminutives. Now I've been practicing on that word pretty much all day. Diminutives. Diminutives.
Diminutives.
In Dutch, diminutives are verkleinwoorden. Verklein is making smaller and woorden are words. So you get making smaller words, literally translated. Now in English, you usually put a word like small or tiny or little before a word or doggy. You know, you have a dog and a doggy. But you don't say house and a housey. You say tiny house. Now in Dutch, we do put a suffix behind every word. We say huisje. So you have a house. And because of the je behind the word house, it becomes a small house. So you have a house and a huis and a huisje. And een hond, which is a dog. And een hondje. And there are several suffixes. Je. Je. Pje, and utje. This probably sounds really weird to you if you're not Dutch. Now, because I'm Dutch, I never really think of the moments when I use je, pje, tje, or kje. But there are rules. You use the suffix je behind words ending in, and now I have to read it, B, C, D, T, F, G, Ch, K, P, V, X, Z, and I can't read my own handwriting. S. Een tas. Een tas is a bag. A tiny bag or a small bag, I don't know what you say in English, is een tas je. It ends on an S, so you put the suffix je behind the word. Okay? So now we're going on to the second suffix, which is tje. When do you use tje? You use tje with words ending in R, N, H, J, L, and W. So, for example, you have the word zoen, which is a kiss. Zoen ends with an N, of course. So you don't put je behind it, but je. And a small kiss, tiny kiss, little kiss becomes zoentje. Violin. In Dutch, violin is viool, een viool. So when you're talking about a small violin, you say viool and put behind the L, tje, so it becomes viooltje. Yeah? Okay, and now we're going to the other suffix, which is pje. Now, when do you use pje? You only use pje when a word ends in M. So, for example, boom. And boom is a tree. And when you're talking about a small tree, you don't say boomje or boomtje, but you say boom pje. So, a boom and a boompje. And now the last one, kje. Words ending in ing will have a suffix kje. So, for example, koning is a king, and a small king becomes een koninkje. And then the last one are those ending in utje, and those are irregular. So yeah, I hope this video helped you a little bit. Some are just irregular, and every language has irregular things. You just have to learn by speaking and just practice a lot, and you'll get there. And I believe in you. And Dutch is hard, but you can do it. And don't worry, most of the words are regular, of course. So just remember, pje, 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 and je, and you can do it.
Broek, broekje. Tas, tasje, boek, boekje, gitaar, gitaartje, t-shirt, t-shirtje, kaars, kaarsje, kussen, kussentje, mes, mesje, vork, vorkje, lepel, lepeltje, spiegel, spiegeltje.